Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here, and in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at ClickUp's Wiki feature. It is a document add-on, a page view that you can have inside of ClickUp. We're going to be exploring it, seeing whether it's a suitable way for you to add stuff if you're utilizing ClickUp or looking at a project management tool. Now, as you can imagine, I didn't discover this on my own. I actually found it through Austin, who actually did a, basically, he came on to do a tour of his ClickUp account and how he uses it with his solar panel company, which was truly amazing. I actually learned, you should be able to watch the interview by now. I'll put it in the link in the description. I actually learned myself a lot about how solar panels work and actually, you know, quite interesting about how they like can actually turn off and, you know, how there could be errors. And he showed how his process with ClickUp and how he manages sort of a field team utilizing it, which was pretty cool. So make sure to watch that video. But this is a feature that you can actually add on to ClickUp. So you can see here that I'm actually on ClickUp. This one went out today. I'm not actively using ClickUp, but it's getting a lot of attention at the moment. So let's go over to the spaces area. So this is showing everything. As you can see here, this is everything, including the YouTube content calendar we created for the last example. As per normal, you can go ahead and add a view. What we mentioned before is very similar to apps like monday.com, Asana. You can add different views like list, board, calendar, box and Gantt. Some of these I believe are premium features, but I'll double check and I'll add that in the description below. But you can see here that there's these new sort of areas and they're conversation and document and embed. Now, embed, you can actually take whatever embed code you've got. So for example, if you and your company have got statistics from say Google Ads or Google Analytics for your website, you know, it could literally be anything. Another project management software that you can utilize the embed just by pasting that in and then you can see that is a nice view. So if you go and type in an embed one, you can actually embed videos, you can embed other Google documents that you currently use, Google Calendar that you may be pretty active on, type forms, etc. So Austin actually had a type form that him and his company filled out after completing a fix on the solar panel, which I thought was pretty cool, a nice sort of in sync process so they don't have to leave ClickUp. You've also got embed HTML as well. So you can actually embed apps like Airtable. You know, they've even got some Miro, Spotify, Gist. I'm not sure what Gist is. I'm sure I'll dive into that soon. Google Maps, etc. So you can embed just simple HTML to be able to port a site in there, which is pretty cool. But the sort of gem that I'm looking at is Doc. Now, obviously, there's been a lot of conversation about project managers and their relevance in a Notion-filled world. Notion is obviously gaining a lot of attention because it's a wiki-like application with project management abilities. But now project managers are adding wiki-like abilities. We saw recently Zenkit, which is another popular project management application. I'll include the link to the video we did about the wiki tool. They recently launched the wiki tool. And you can see there, you can be able to turn any of your boards into wiki experiences, allowing you and your team to have valuable documents nearby, or maybe education around, you know, new employee onboards. But this is actually coming into play in ClickUp. So you can see here that you can go ahead and create this. They call it a doc, but I'm going to call it a wiki. And you can even in the personal, in the business plan, actually have it as personal views. So for example, if you wanted to have, you know, your own secure wiki. But in this case, anything, any new doc that you're sharing here is going to be shared team-wide so they can have access to this. So what I'm going to say here is it's not incredibly advanced, but what it's nice about it is that if you're using a project manager like this, you don't necessarily need to get something like Notion or Coda or something else like that. You could maybe navigate you know, boards, for example, here and then go over to your wiki and find it pretty easily. So it's this concept of sticking to one application all in one workspace that is a big conversation right now. And I can imagine as a business or someone like that, you're probably wanting to sort of move to that model. So here it's very simple. You can move pages up and down, obviously. You can go ahead and rename them. You can add a page inside that, which is quite nice. So for example, if I put this one as home. What I could do then is I could add new onboards. So this could be used for when a team member comes on board, and I could drag that inside of the home. So if I go to home, obviously that's going to be available inside it, which is really nice. So I could have a nice, you know, if I'd clicked it, welcome to the company. We're so glad to have you. So you get the concept. You can add whatever text you like here. So what's quite cool is if I open this editing up, you can see here that I can add anything from heading 1 to heading 3, checklists, dividers, tables, inline code, as well as, you know, numeric lists and backgrounds as well. But what's quite nice is you can also embed other apps like Cloud App, YouTube, Vimeo, Figma, Loom, which are all used for explaining software. So for example, if I added a YouTube video, if I typed in YouTube, I could type the URL there and be able to get maybe an onboarding or the company values just as a video. So let me go and grab that one. I literally just grabbed what was on the top of YouTube just to give you an example. And you can see here that it just appears pretty nicely in line, and you can watch that video, which is very easy to use. And you can even turn it large as well. Is it large? There you go. You can turn it small or large to make it playable, but you can even increase the size and the depth of it as well. So there we go. That's quite a nice addition, I think. When you land on the page, you can have a video to introduce you, and you could have that through Loom or Cloud App or one of the others. Up here, you can see that it saves automatically, which is nice because autosave is brilliant. Shared, you can actually share it outside in a public link, which is very helpful if you add external clients. You can also see an ongoing revision history, which is nice, of any updates that were made. So that might be helpful if you've got lots of team members and are adding lots more to it. You can even upload files through Dropbox, OneDrive, or through your computer, as well as through Box, Drive, or even create a Google file through it as well. You can import and export. You can import from HTML and Markdown, and you can export into PDF, HTML, and Markdown, which is helpful, again, if you're looking to share. For example, let's say you and your team want to improve your wiki. You could print it off, sit down, and actually start writing on it in terms of structure and how you want it to look. So as you can imagine, it's as simple as that. I don't think the Zenkit wiki was more advanced than this. Up in the top right-hand corner, you've got search, which you can have site-wide. But once you start doing, for example, once you start adding new wiki stuff, obviously it should all be able to detect it. And that will obviously see it as a wiki and take you to that location, which it has done there. So that's obviously a bit more about the wiki feature and the doc tool. But there was actually a feature called Notepad, which is more of a personal note-taking tool. But again, it's something that is available as well. I don't see them. Maybe it's sort of a bit complicated, I guess. You've got the Notepad for your own personal notes, and you've got the Wiki and Doc tool for your own sort of needs, for the team needs. And you can have your own personal one. So I see they're slightly different, I guess. This one's more for quick notes. This one's more for, coordinating team information. But it's quite exciting. I see this game becoming very interesting. I say game, but I mean, it just becomes very interesting. As they become more competitive with each other, project managers are going to get better. All-in-one workspaces are going to get stronger and more reliable. So that's always good news for the end user. So guys, a big thank you. Hopefully this video gave you some information about ClickUp, and you can find a link to ClickUp below if you decide to go with it. But a big thank you. If you're not subscribed yet, hit subscribed. If you like this video, naturally hit like. But it's been a pleasure, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.